Okay, we're going to talk about anatomy of hand x-rays and answer the question, what anatomy can you see on AP oblique and lateral hand x-rays? Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Morton, and I'm the noted anatomist. Okay, so the standard hand series of x-rays consists of the following. First, a PA view, the posterior anterior view, where the hand is placed flat down on the viewing machine, and the x-rays go through the back of the hand first. Posterior to anterior. Next is an oblique view where the hand is at an angle, and then the next thing is a lateral view. So it looks like this, PA, oblique, and lateral. And so the x-rays are like this, a PA view, an oblique view, and a lateral view, like that. Now the PA view is taken like that, but we view the image like this. So then we do the PA, oblique, and lateral. PA, oblique, and lateral. So let's start with the PA view of the right hand. It looks like this. And so this is the PA view is good for demonstrating the carpals, metacarpals, phalanges, radius, and ulna, and its anatomical position. Really good for metacarpals. And it's also good to take a look if a patient may have rheumatoid arthritis or osteoarthritis. So let's take a look at some structures. So first, there's that bone right there, which is the radius. And on the radius, and there it is on the surface anatomy, and the radius has this bony sticky outie. It's called the styloid process of the radius, and that's right there on the wrist. Then we have this bone on the opposite side, which is the ulna. And the ulna has this bony sticky outie. That's the styloid process of the ulna. And below that, or just proximal to that, is this head of the ulna, that is that big bump on the back of the wrist like that. Okay, so then there's this collection of bones called the carpals, and the carpals is Greek for wrist, and that's the wrist bones that are right there, two rows of eight bones, and those eight bones, if we then put an imaginary line through, are four proximal carpal bones and a row of four distal carpal bones. And there are the first letters of each of them. And you might be saying, hey, how do you remember all the carpal bones and in order? Well, I remember them through a simple mnemonic. Sally left the party to take Kathy home. I went to a religious university, so I didn't learn all those other more colorful mnemonics that people use. So let's do that again, shall we? So let's take this S and say, what is S? It's that bone right there, and S is for scaphoid bone, which is Greek for boat, because if you look at it, it kind of looks like a boat. Scaphoid bone, it makes a big articulation with the distal end of the radius, and also has a very unique blood supply to watch out for avascular necrosis if it's fractured. And then we have this other bone right here, and that is the L for lunate, and lunate is Latin for moon, because if we take a look at the lunate bone and blow it up, it kind of looks like a half moon. Then we have the next bone, which is a T, and T stands for triquetrum. Tri for three, quadrum. Oh my heavens, I can't even pronounce it. It's Latin for three corners because it articulates with three bones, the hamate, the lunate, and the pisiform bone. Next we have P, that one right there, which is pisiform, which is Latin for P-shaped because it looks like a green pea. This is a sesamoid bone. It's the last of the eight carpal bones to form, and it's sesamoid because it's really in the tendon of the flexor carpal ulnaris. It's the only bone that, it's only carpal bone it articulates with is a triquetrum, right, that's on. Next T is for this bone right here, which is the trapezium. And I remember it because the trapezium articulates with the thumb. Thumb trapezium. And right beside it is this other bone that has the exact same derivation, which is trapezoid, which is Latin for table. So trapezium and trapezoid both have this Latin derivation dealing with table. Evidently looks like a table, like you could play poker on it. All right, this next one, the letter C, is this bone right here. It gets C for capitate because capitate is Latin for head. And there we have the capitate bone. You look at it, yeah, it kind of looks like a head. The next bone we're going to talk about is this one right here, and that is the hamate, which is Latin for hook, because that little structure there is called the hamulus, or hook, of the hamate. So we look at this palmar surface where the hand is face up, and there is that hook, whereas the x-ray is the back surface of the hand face down, where it looks kind of like this. There the asterisk is showing the hamate, the hamulus of the hamate, and watch. You look at the back surface, and there it is in the asterisk. And so if you then toggle from the palm surface of the hand forward, or the back surface, is the hand touching the table, or the back of the hand touching the table, you get an idea of where the hamulus of the hamate is on x-ray. All right, so there we now have a group of bones that are called the metacarpals. And there they are on the back of the hand here. And the prefix meta means after or beyond the carpals. These are the bones, the metacarpals are the bones after the wrist. And there are five of them. One on the thumb is makes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so there are those five carpal bones. They're the bones you see in the palm of the hand. And there is the head of a metacarpal, which is distal, forming the metacarpal phalangeal joint. And then the base is the one that articulates with the carpal bones. Next, we have these bones here, and these are the phalanges. And the phalanges are numbered 1 for thumb, 2 for index finger, 3 for square finger, 4 for ring finger, and 5 for pinky. And so there on the thumb is a proximal and a distal phalange. And then you have a proximal, middle, and distal part of the digits in the digits 2 through 5. All right, so let's do some joints. So there between the radius and the carpal, specifically the scaphoid and the lunate, is the radiocarpal joint. It's a synovial joint. And then over here between the ulna and then really the triquetrum and part of the lunate, there is a structure called the TFCC, the triangular fibrocartilaginous complex. And it's a cushion support between the ulna bone and this proximal row of carpals, specifically lunate and triquetrum. Next joint is there, and this is between the carpals and the metacarpals. It's called the carpometacarpal joint, all in that gray area. Then we also have this joint between the metacarpals and the phalanges, which is the metacarpal phalangeal joint, MCP joint. Then we have this next joint between the proximal and middle phalange that they call it the proximal interphalangeal joint. And then there's another joint between phalanges, and it's called the distal interphalangeal joint. And pretty much all in medicine, they just call them the DIP, PIP, and then also the MCP. They're the big ones. Okay, so let's talk about the hand in oblique view in this fashion. So this is an oblique projection of the hand, and it's also good for looking for overlap. And so there we've got the phalanges, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the metacarpals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then there are the carpal bones, the radius, and the ulna. So let's zoom in on the carpal bones, and there Sally left the party. There we have that pisiform. To take Kathy home. And so there are the carpal bones all outlined there in this oblique view. Now let's take a look at the hand in a lateral view on the right side. And there we have it. The x-ray is going through. And so when we take a look at this lateral view, there is our phalanges. And there's digit 1, which is the thumb. And then the other 4 are all overlapped. Now the benefit of the lateral projection, that's 90 degrees to the PA view, is that you can see if there's any, you see all the carpal bones that are overlapping, and so you're able to see if there's a fracture displacement. So the phalanges is not as much, and the metacarpals the same, you see that overlap, but those carpal bones, that's when you might be able to see overlapping. And also if there's a foreign body that's sticking through the hand, it's easier to see on this. And then there is a radius and ulna. And that, my friends, is the anatomy of hand x-rays in a nutshell.